Hey, I'm Jerry. And if you're like me and trying to work more from your iOS devices, then you might be wondering how to perform certain tasks on iOS that you do without even thinking on a laptop or desktop. Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you four ways to transfer files between two iOS devices. Let's start with what is probably the most difficult way to transfer files between iOS devices, and that's with a USB drive. So if this is all new to you, you might be thinking, Jerry, how can a USB drive connect to an iPad or an iPhone? It's got USB when the iPhone has Lightning and the iPad has either Lightning or USB-C. Well, that's where dongles come in. For this transfer, I'm going to be using a Lightning to USB cable and a USB-A to USB-C adapter. Now, one thing to note quickly is that not all USB drives are made the same. Some require more power and may or may not work with your iPhone directly. If that's the case, you might have to find a USB drive with external power, or you can use something like a micro SD card reader, which would work as well and require less power. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to connect my USB-A to USB-C adapter onto this USB drive like that and insert it into the iPad. When you insert the USB drive, it's going to show up on the left side of the Files app. I'm going to be copying some files from this local temp folder here, and I'm going to hit select the items, and hit move. Over here, I'm going to select the USB drive and hit copy. You can see the progress of the file copy up here, although it's very limited. So now we have the files actually on the USB drive, and we're going to take that out and plug that into the iPhone. Of course, since the iPhone doesn't have USB, we're going to use this USB-C to Lightning adapter and plug it in that way. So as you can see, now on the iPhone, we have the USB drive attached. We can go in here and see the files that we copied over. We're going to select those. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to hit the little file button at the bottom. And we're going to select the location where we want it, which is going to be on my iPhone. And I'm going to select local temp again and copy. Now, if we go to that folder on the iPhone, you'll see the files exist there as well. All right, so the next way that we're going to get files from one device to another is using iCloud. And to do that, we're just going to download an image from Safari. So here we have an image of Earth. We're going to long press down here, click download linked file, and we can see it here. If we go back to the Files app, it's going to show up in our downloads folder. Now, this download folder is actually sitting on iCloud already. So if you go to iCloud Drive, downloads, here's the exact same folder, which means that any device that you're signed in with iCloud will also get the exact same files. So let's look on the iPhone. So on the iPhone, if we go back to Browse and go to Downloads, right there we have earth.whatever.png file. Although you'll see the little cloud icon over here on the side, that means that it's in iCloud Drive, it's just not downloaded to the device. If you want to download it to the device, you just tap and there it goes. Now the file lives on both devices. Now you can also do this with files that already exist on the iPad or iPhone, but you have to account for the upload times if it's a large file to iCloud and then the download to the new device. Now this also works with other cloud services like OneDrive or Google Drive or even Adobe Creative Cloud files if that's something you use. However, I have seen some issues with OneDrive, for example, where I upload a file on one device and it takes quite a long time for it to show up as even being available on the other one. The third way that we can transfer files from one device to another is using AirDrop. If we look at that same earth.png file that we used before, I'm going to tap and hold, and then I'm going to hit share. And then over here on AirDrop, you're gonna see a couple of devices. I'm going to send it to my iPhone. And right away, the iPhone's gonna grab it. And because it's a picture file, it's going to open up Photos directly. So this copied it directly into the Photos application because of the file type that it is, instead of putting it inside the Files application, maybe inside of a folder that you wanted to. We're going to do the same thing with this LumaFusion backup file. We're going to long press and hit share. Going to go into AirDrop and going to tap on my phone. We're going to wait for the file to transfer. On the iPhone, it's going to copy over, and because of the file type, open up LumaFusion. Now this is a great, fast, easy way to transfer files between devices, but what if you don't want it to go directly into the Photos app or open up in a specific application? Well, Now, you can copy and paste as well between devices. If we look at that same LumaFusion file, which opened up automatically when we transferred it over to the iPhone, we're going to do this a little bit different. We're just going to tap and hold and click copy. And now, because of the way that Handoff works inside iOS, we can just go to the iPhone, navigate to the directory we want to use, find an empty space and tap and hold, and hit paste. And as you can see, the file, just like with AirDrop, is copying directly over from the iPad to the iPhone using Wi-Fi. However, this time, the file does not automatically open up in the application that it's designated for, and you can place it wherever you want within the file system. So that's the four ways that I know of to copy files between iOS devices: a USB drive, cloud services, AirDrop, and copy paste. So if this video was helpful and helps your iOS productivity, let me know with a thumbs up. If I missed something or there's a completely easier way to do this that I didn't even mention, then let me know in the comments below. You can follow me on Twitter @JerrySchultz for video updates, and I'll see you next time.